Amen.
Amen.
If you have your Bibles, I want to ask that you will join with me in the book of Matthew, 27th chapter. Around about the 45th and 46th verse. If you don't mind, I'm marking Luke, the 23rd chapter. The 46th verse. As a point of reference. Matthew, the 27th. 45th verses where we were beginning. Give honor to the Lord our God and to our Savior Jesus Christ. Thank God for Jesus.
Thank God for Jesus.
There's somebody say, ooh, thank you, Jesus. That's where I'm at. Holy Spirit, our guide and our comfort.
Feel so alone.
So, alone.
Yeah.
You're not far from me. Trouble is near. There is no one to help. Many bulls have surrounded me, strong bulls, fast. They have encircled me. They open wide their mouth at me as a raving and roaring lion. I am poured out with all my bones are out of joint. My heart is like wax, it's melting within me. My strength is all dried up like a potsherd. My tongue cleaves to my jaws. Thou dost lay me in the dust. The dogs have surrounded me, a band of evildoers has encompassed me. They pierced my hands and my feet. I can count all my bones. They look, they stare at me. They divide my garments among them. For my clothing be cast out. And these are the words written by the psalmist, which I believe echo the sound of Jesus. See him on the cross. Lifted high. I hear all around him a crowd talking and laughing among themselves. I see on his left and his right side two male thugs. And they are there. Enduring suffering. Shame and sorrow. I see Mary Magdalene, Mary, the mother of Jesus. I see three Marys there. And I see one of the disciples called John, who he calls the beloved disciple, who has already said, woman, look at your son. The son, behold. And in his face I see not only the pain from the physical, not only the anguish from the mental. See the sorrow in his spirit. I hear all of the other words that he proclaimed. But this word, heal. Eli, Eli, Tabitha, this word right here. It bothers me. Because when I translate the Greek, the Hebrew, when I break it down into English, in my mind, I hear Jesus say, my God. My God! Why hast thou forsaken me?
Right.
I feel alone. I need to talk.
talk to you about this. I need to also preach and teach at the same time to help somebody.
Yes.
If not everybody.
That's right. Amen.
Because I perceive that in life, if you keep saying good morning, you're going to have some days where you feel alone.
Yes. Amen.
No, I need you to pray with me on this one. And you can be, listen to me, you can be a married woman.
Amen.
I don't need nobody here. You can be a married man.
Yes.
And still
feel alone.
Feel alone.
Yes.
You can have a great family.
Yes.
Supporting you all around.
Yes.
You can have friends like nobody else. You could have folk calling you all kinds of titles,
yes,
and names, and
yes,
acknowledging you on many levels.
Yes.
And with all of that going on in your life, you can still
feel
alone. And hope today right here in this church house.
Yeah.
You can be smiling and laughing, cutting up, looking all glad on the outside, but on the inside, you can still feel alone. I need you to take a note from me right here. I need you to take a note from me. Here's a note that I'm going to give you. I need you to understand that there is a difference. There is, Lord help me, Holy Ghost, there is a difference between a feeling and a fact.
That's right.
I need you to understand there is a difference. There is a difference. And sometimes I've got to encourage myself in the Lord and remind myself that there is a difference between a feeling and a fact. Not every feeling is a fact, and not every fact is a feeling. But there is a difference between the two, and I thank God because sometimes I feel alone.
That's right, amen.
But the fact of the matter is, I'm not alone.
Yeah.
I need you to get this down in your spirit because I guarantee you that if you bring it back to yourself in those times, it's going to help you. Sometimes you can feel like you are alone. You can feel like you're alone because you can feel so drained. And you can feel like so many people have taken from you and nobody has given back. And nobody appreciates you. When I think about Jesus on the cross, understand why it is that he could be discouraged and disheartened, because he had given so much, he had done so much, he had been an awesome Savior, he had been a man without sin and without the hope, he was a lamb without spot or wrinkle, but yet he was the one that was lifted up and crucified. So you got the excuse me.
Thank you.
That's why the Bible lets us know that the feelings that we have, the experiences that we go through, the trials and the tribulation, the struggles that we have to deal with in the flesh, Jesus knows all about. I'm grateful for this scripture because if it didn't have this scripture, I would feel like he always felt like he was in good company. always, and can I help somebody by telling you, you can be saved and sanctified, but still fall victim to stealing. It is a feeling.
Yes.
Y'all know something, I tell y'all all the time. Sometimes I feel like a nut. And sometimes I don't. My feelings sometimes can be high and sometimes they can be low. But I have to remind myself that there is a difference between a feeling and a fact. You can feel like you have nobody, but yet at the same time, there can be so many people just waiting to rise up on your behalf. I need you to understand and pause yourself and realize that this feeling will pass.
Yes, it will.
Do not become overwhelmed with one moment of feeling. And even if it seems like the night of this feeling is long, the Bible is right when it says that weeping endures for the night of joy.
That's right.
Yeah. out of my life.
Yes.
And I get mad. And I feel frustrated.
Yeah.
And quite honestly,
yeah.
I get puffed up and worked up.
Yeah.
All right. Even to the point to where as I just get even with God.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Because I don't feel like it's fair. His mold.
Yes.
In his shaping and in his making.
Yes.
And in his turning. And as he is tweaking me, he's removing out of my life some impurity.
Yes.
He knows me better than I know myself.
Yes.
I think I can handle certain things, but God knows me better than I know myself.
Yes.
And he knows that sometimes he got to put me by myself in order for me to really pray right.
Oh, I'll get back to you.
two of us.
Amen.
When it was just the two of us.
Yes.
Everything I did, you told me thank you.
Mm.
But now that that other person that come on the scene, now that you got another distraction, I'm no longer your main attraction. And when I'm not your main attraction, that tells me I need to get rid of the distraction.
Wow.
I value my relationship with you. And so God, because he loves you so much, he will not suffer anything else in your life that is going to demote him from being God.
Come on.
Boy, that's a lot of good.
Oh, yes.
Let me take you back to when you was alone with God.
Yeah.
You was eating up that word.
Yeah.
Come on.
Hungry and thirsty.
Yeah.
His righteousness. Trying to live right.
Yeah.
Trying to earn some rounding points with God. Maybe if I act right, maybe if I think right, maybe if I talk right, maybe if I get myself together, maybe if I follow God and then allow him to order myself, he might have blessed me and he might have seen that I can be trusted, that I can be trusted with somebody else. And so I got myself together, and no sooner than somebody else walked into my life, now all of a sudden God has to play a certain string. Let me tell you something, put this in your note. God will tell you today, I'm never going to be your side piece. Point number one was a fact and a feeling are different. Feeling is not a fact.
All right.
And a fact is not a feeling. They're two different things. Point number two that I want to make you praise your progress.
Yes.
Your purpose. Wait a minute, I didn't say nothing about the purpose part, did I? Your purpose.
Yes.
Sometimes requires you to be alone.
All right.
Because when you are alone, God and you will work on your purpose. But I've noticed that when you become distracted, you're not interested in pleasing the Lord so much. You want to please somebody else. Trying to please somebody. So now when you get your hamburger, you won't even say Jesus will.
Come on.
Y'all don't want it. I wish I had a little answer. Or agree to the word. It ain't got to be my word. I don't want you to agree to that. But you ought at least to agree to the word of God. People get all twisted now. Oh, you can't preach anymore. Because preaching don't work with any old woman. Because that don't work with your man. Oh, you feel bad. Because Sundays you used to be in church, but because Saturday night you was at the club.
What?
Help me with those.
Yeah.
Woo! God ain't interested.
Amen.
In sharing you with the devil. Can I say that one more time?
Yeah.
God is not interested in sharing you with the devil. That's why I heard when Joshua said, choose ye this day whom you will serve. But as for me and my house, we don't serve. Can I tell you this? Man, woman, boy, or girl who chooses God as first in their life will never lose. But anybody who does not choose God first will never win. That's for those who was listening. Let me give you this thing. Sometimes you are alone because you have, sometimes you feel alone because you have chosen religion.
Come on.
Over relationship. Now God has already promised you is never going to leave us. Never forsake us. He's already promised us that he is a present help. He reminds us that he ain't going nowhere. His word ain't going to change. You can trust him. He's the same God today as he was yesterday, as he will be on tomorrow.
To help somebody in need.
You can help them
and not worry about them ever helping you.
Right.
I believe one time the Bible said, even those in the world will do that kind of stuff. But when it comes to the children of God, we are required to help folk and never expect of them to help us.
Glory! Glory, glory!
And that's why Sister Rachel, I've learned that all of my help
comes from him.
It must come from
him. Yes.
That the Lord will give and the Lord will take away. Still, I raise my hand and say,
blessed be the name of the Lord. Oh, yes.
Oh, Lord. I understand why some of those that he healed did not rise up and say, I'm here for you, Jesus. But in the 10 lepers that were healed,
only
nine of them were healed.
Yes.
And kept on. Tell me, God, oh,
girl. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I am. I sin and fallen short. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I am. Yes, and I messed up and undone.
Can you see?
Yes.
In your hand.
Father's love.
Yes, our Father.
Waiting patiently,
in my life. The Lord was there. All the time. You are there.
The Lord was there.